So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Rutgers Scarlet Knights and the St. Mary's Gaels.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Gaels might have a little trouble with these guys, Dick. Keys to their success depends on what?
Hey, the keys to their success tonight are simple. First, reward your big man. Give him the ball down low. Get him into the game. Let him be part of the offense. Secondly, make sure every possession you have is a good possession. Don't turn the rock over. Lastly, if you win the glass, baby, and you own the boards, you'll win the game.
I couldn't agree more with you, partner. Let's get down to the court and join the action.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He attempts the three. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Looking for a good shot. On the outside, he attempts the trifecta, drains it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The small forward takes the pass. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Dumps it in. Looking for contact. Number 50 makes the finger roll. Number three takes the feed. For two, way off target. He may be in trouble here. On the dribble, gives it up. Entry pass in the paint. Time to pick up the defense here now.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Leans in. Tickles a twine. Gave it up. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Number 32 with the theft. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. The shooting guard with the ball. He shoots from left of the circle. He buried that one from way deep. And our trifecta for the Knights. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. We're Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessel. Nice to have you along with us. Trying to feed inside. Fake. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
Number 32 gets the pass. He fakes the shot. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
They look to get it to the inside. Trying to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby. Trying to go inside.
In the paint. He looks at the hoop. He goes with a jump hook. They still don't score. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Lost some ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Number 15 gets the ball. Draws the foul and gets the basket.
He's into it. Win, baby. That's his name. I like that in a player.
Number 32 going to the charity line for the first time tonight. He gets it to go. the dribble, gives it up. Number 50 is eager and excited to compete.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
They work the perimeter. Adam, momentary look from three-point land. Got the high pick. He shoots from right of the circle. He doesn't get the hoop. Wow, the defender got the worst of that hard screen.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
First shot is good. Second shot is no good. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
They push it up on the break. For the bucket, perfectly executed. Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and add a spin move to the goal.
The Gaels are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. Gave it up. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down here in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Takes the pass in the paint. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He's open if he wants the shot. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
From the top of the circle, he shows a sweet touch.
You can see on the replay how this one goes down.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Turnaround jumper. Doesn't go. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Those long arms trying to get him in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
On the inside. Another turnover.
We're not talking out for turnovers either.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Gave it up. Takes the pass in the paint. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Working it around the perimeter. He launches a three. That's an ill-advised shot.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
He goes with a baby hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Off the rim and no good. And he scores despite the hack. Puts it up looking for contact. That was nice.
Let's take a look at that last hoop.
Fires away, way off target. Looking for the foul. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
They work it around the perimeter. Number two draws the personal. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Two goes to the line for the first time. First shot is no good. Count it. Two for one opportunity. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
On the guy in the post to go the other way. There they come with a double team to stop it. He shoots from long range. Goes in. Shot clock is dead. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to go. Goes.
There it is again.
And the ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Kicks it out. He goes for three. Oh, yes. At the half. The Scarlet Knights trail by one. Well, it's been a close one so far, Dick Vitale. What's your take on the play of the half?
This one's big for me, Brad. The long trifecta. Shots like this can sometimes get a team going in a hurry.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron.
Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
He makes the shot. The inside. If not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just
that one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, Eli?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
around the perimeter. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Basket falls despite the contact. Both teams looking to get things going here. From top of the circle, it's good. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Looking for a good shot. Shot rejected, and the ball goes out of play. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
On the dribble, gives it up.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there, baby.
That's exactly what they expect from him. That young man is doing some great things for this program, Dick.
Hey, Brad, he's what I call a PTP-er, a prime-time player. When the spotlight is on, he usually performs.
In the paint. Number 50 fakes the shot. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
There's the pick. He fires away. Off the rim and no good. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
For the bucket and off the mark. Stolen. Change in possession. The defense knocked it loose, then went and got it. In the paint. Jump hook from the low post. And in and out. Gave it up. The center handles the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Looks at the three. Scorches the net. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17. He posterized it.
Number 24 steps to the line for the first time. Good. The perimeter. High screen. The point guard receives the pass. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
Great defense. Gave it up. Dribble, gives it up. Number 24 picks up the foul. First team foul. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
All right, thanks, Erin. On the outside. Top of the circle.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet Jed.
He intercepts it. The point guard receives the ball. looking for a good shot. The small forward handles the feed. He tries to knock down the three. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they like shooting the ball.
Gave it up. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
At some point, his team is going to have to step up and play at his level. He's carrying them right now.
On the dribble, gives it up. They work it around the perimeter. Shoots it. Off the rim and no good. Now they work it around the perimeter.
Right there, they missed him.
He blocks the shot. And now, coming the other way, there's a slam. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Right in the circle, way off target.
Spacing.
Intercepted. He's money with a shot. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots kill chemistry, Brad.
Momentary look from three-point land. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
That one puts the personal in person. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Gave it up. Controlling the ball. Robs him of the ball. Looking for a good shot. In the paint. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Tries for two. He drains the bucket.
Good defensive pressure. Head right on the ball. Drive him to the spot you'd like to take him and beat him.
He strokes it. Perfectly designed, perfectly executed. Easy basket. Timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
The lead is nine.
Nine is fine, Brad. They have to keep their composure and take good shots.
He can't get the hoop to fall. The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups. This defender is resilient, still applying pressure.
Takes the outside jumper. He doesn't get the hook. On the outside. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Moving it around the perimeter. Picks off the lazy pass.
Up it inside.
With the fake. Good fake. Goes with a jump hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ball game. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
Number 50 wants the crowd to get fired up and involved.
Hey, Brad, I think he wants the crowd backing him up on his next possession.
He goes to the free throw line. He makes the front end of the one and one. Sinks it. We've got a timeout. Dick and I'll be back in a moment.
That's a good TO, baby.
We're about ready to hit the floor. Goes up for two, rims out. Here they go into transition. Steals the pass. For the deuce, sweet looking shot.
He is super, he really is.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing, that leads you to the exit sign. No question, you get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy, I love that. Gets his second. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
He tries the three.
Nice job of using the screen to get open for that good shot.
And yet another foul. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in post games.
Got it! They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
He shoots from the angle. Off the rim and no good.
Look at that great defense right there. Not allowing them to make the turn.
All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on, one team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball, they made sure they converted on the free throw line, and did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Scarlet Knights is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.